position or self-defense. Open guard is in a position where I don't really have control of him. He doesn't really have control of me. I'm not at a distance where strikes are going to be effective, okay? But he's also not at a distance where he feels like he can stand up safely. Right? If we're in this distance and Sullivan went to go to try to stand up from here, I'm going to be on top of him. I'm going to grab his head. I'm going to headlock him, right? I'm going to take his back. And vice versa, if I hang out in this kind of position too long without being smart, he's in a very good position to use his legs to upkick me and create more distance. Okay, so this is kind of open guard, let's call it. And there's a lot of different variations on open guard, especially when you're talking sport jiu-jitsu. There's a lot of different positions that classify under open guard. But again, with a self-defense mindset, we're going to be kind of here in this position. Alright, again, he tries to upkick me, like, I'm kind of at a little bit too far of a distance, right? I'm not at a good enough distance where I can punch him, so we're kind of even, so to speak. Okay, so that's what open guard is, alright? So, first thing we're going to do is we're going to do a drill on how to stay facing the person, okay? If Sullivan just stays where he is, and I move around his legs, and I can get past his guard, right? So that's the easiest way to do it. But again, he's just kind of laying there, and I pass his guard like that. Okay, great, okay? So first we're gonna work on the bottom person. That's what we're gonna focus on. Top guy, all I want you to do is I want you to just move around the person like a clock. Okay, they're gonna be standing on a clock. I'm just gonna shuffle my feet around, just like that. He's gonna follow, okay? He can do it by rocking his hips up like a little pendulum, right? But if he does it that way, there's a split second where his hips are off the ground, where if I do a little shuck and jive and go the other way, he's not gonna be able to stop his body in momentum. Okay? So if I'm going this way, he rocks his hips off the ground, he rocks his hips off, I can time it and go the other way. Okay? So, better idea, let's switch, is so let's have contact with the mat. Okay, right? Anytime we can have contact with the mat and move our body, we can always change the direction of whatever we need to do to stay facing the person. So, as Sullivan starts to walk, whatever direction he's going, I want to put that foot on the ground and then use that to turn my hip. Okay? Now if he moves around, I can use this foot. So if he decides to switch direction really quick, I have something that's moving my hip. So notice I'm just moving my hip very, very little in order to move around and stay in front of the person. Okay? And now if he were to go to the other direction, left foot goes down. Notice how I'm just moving myself just a little bit. If he decides to change direction, it's a quick little foot move, and now I'm back in front of him, okay? So it's just a drill, just to teach you how to keep somebody in front of you in this open guard position. So he goes one way, foot goes to the floor, so I just slide my hip over. He goes the other way, switch. Notice how I still have one foot up. If he decides to charge, I have one foot that can create some kind of a barrier. I can do an up kick, and then we'll learn how to maintain this guard if he maybe grabs my leg and tries to pass my guard that way. But let's just start with a simple drill of just trying to stay in front of the person. So again, that's it. Head and shoulders are off the ground. He's gonna switch. He's gonna switch, yeah. It's gonna be very hard for him to like out-jive me here. Because all I'm doing is just rotating. Okay? Any questions? Very simple. Let's just start with that drill. Good. So just a very simple drill on how to stay in front of the person. Easy. Okay? Now, let's say I do that, right? I do that, and he's following me. Huh? Great. Now this foot that's up, maybe I grab it. Right? What happens if I grab it? Right? This is gonna be like a leg drag scenario, okay? Leg drag is a technique on how to pass the guard, okay? But instinctually, it's just, oh, there's a leg in my way, let me grab it, get out of my way, and I can pass the guard, right? So things don't have to be like super technical, right? They can just be as simple as like, throw the leg out of the way and pass the guard. Okay, so what happens if I do that, right? Sullivan, I just pull, if he doesn't do anything, I'm just gonna pull his leg out of the way, now I got him in side control, I mount him, now he's in a bad spot, all right? So we're just gonna start with both legs up, just to do the drill, because maybe he grabs one of us, so don't worry about this drill now, okay? I'm just gonna have both feet in the air, he's gonna do that, he's gonna grab one leg, he's gonna drag it across, yeah. Okay? Just a very simple leg drag, okay? So, I'm just gonna have, he's just gonna grab my leg, okay? Now, because he has my leg, I can actually use that connection to lift my hip off the ground. Okay, when I lift my hip off the ground, now I have the ability to rotate my body wherever I need to. Okay, so if he pulls this leg across the body, okay, what I want to do is I want to try to bring this leg, and I want to swing it around and cut him off in that direction. Okay, but it's hard to do that with my hips on the ground. If my hips are on the ground, they can't swivel. Right? If he tries to do that, I don't lift my hip off the ground and I just try to put the foot there, he's going to kill that. It's nothing. There's nothing behind it. My spine is all twisted when my body's like this. There's no strength to it. Okay, so now when he does that, if I lift my hip And now I can place my foot on something. Now my body's in a better alignment to where I can stay connected to him, or I can also push him away and pull my leg out of his control. And then I can start right back in the beginning, okay? But notice how when he grabbed it, I used my leg to circle. See how I turn my hips around? That's the idea of this leg weave, okay? And just basically trying to find something with that weaving leg. So I don't have to aim for the thigh or aim for the knee. Okay, generally like center mass. So if you aim for like the upper thigh, stomach area, okay, you're probably gonna find something. If you aim for the knee, like it's a very small space, right? So if you miss, now he's got an even better position on you because now so if we go here, if I do that and then I miss, and now he's on top of me with this like smash position, all right? So again, don't aim for like something in particular. Center mass is good. You usually end up finding some kind of like a flat place to put your foot so that you can push away and square yourself back up. So that's all we're gonna do. He's gonna grab the leg, I'm gonna lift my hip, and I'm gonna circle my top leg over. See now that I found that nice little spot in the hip? Make sure it's a good flat surface, okay? Not just the heel or just my toes, flat, boom. And now again, I can use that to pull my leg out, push him away, and now I'm squaring back up, ready to do whatever I have to. Okay, so again, this is the leg drag with the leg weave guard retention. So he goes leg drag, I go leg weave. Push off and square back up. He grabs the other leg. Boom. Okay. Notice his footwork. As he pulls my leg across, he starts to shuffle his way towards my body. Okay. So again, he grabs, boom, boom. Hips nice and high. Find that good flat place. Push him away and square back up. Goes the other way. Boom. Okay, he goes again. Boom. I don't care what it is. Find anything. As long as it's a nice flat surface, it's usually going to be that right there. Kick that leg out, and now we're back to our open guard position. Okay? Very simple. Any questions? Okay, let's work. That's a very simple leg weave to keep our open guard. Okay? Really just preventing the guard pass. Sometimes you can do a leg weave and they can try to smash you and then you end up in like maybe half guard or something like that. Like, so a lot of things can happen, but as long as they don't pass your guard, okay, whether you end up in open guard again or maybe you went down to the ground and now you get them in half guard or something like that, that can happen, right? So we're not necessarily always looking to get back to open guard, all right? But we want to get him not to pass my guard. That's the big thing, okay? So next one, so if Sullivan's down, right? So that was the first one. That was a leg drag pass with a leg weave guard retention technique, okay? So that's only really applicable if I grab one leg, right? Because now he has a free leg to come around and cut me off the path, okay? Now we're gonna talk about a bullfighter pass, right? Bullfighter pass is where I got one hand on each leg, okay? So now there's not a free leg to kind of swing around, all right? So I can do a bullfighter pass with usually two approaches. I can do a bullfighter pass. All I'm basically doing is just throwing both of his legs out of the way, okay? So I end up in this bullfighter type position, okay? So that's what I call the bullfighter pass. So I can usually approach with like a high position where I do the bullfighter pass and I end up knee to belly, and then I can drive my weight to the mount. Or I can go low where I shut the legs back and then I dive with my chest, okay? So either way, it's more or less gonna be the same type of technique, all right? So, if my legs are not going to be able to stop the person's progression to passing my guard, I have to find the next best frame, which is usually my hands, okay? So the second he throws my legs out of the way, I have to find the first thing that gets in front of me, and I'm going to use a good, nice, a stiff straight arm, and I'm going to block their forward progression. So whatever, let's just go with a high guard, boom, right here. First thing here, maybe you're here. Okay, depending on what it is, it doesn't really matter. First thing that you see that's getting close to you, I want to have two hands on it. You can have one hand on each leg, it doesn't matter. But notice how, boom, nice forehand, straight arm. Now from here, I make space by shrimping. And then I can either weave my leg back inside by hooking onto his leg now, and I use that to pull myself back to the square position. Okay, again, boom, one, square myself back up. All right, that's the easiest way to do it. Okay. Another way you can do it is he shucks, I can frame, push, and now this top leg can find a position first, and that can help me wind myself back up Okay, however I get back to this open guard position is fine. It doesn't really matter exactly which technique you do, but the big thing is framing against the first thing that gets in your way or the first thing that comes forward, okay? If he does the high guard position, it's usually gonna be the legs. And the next one we'll go over is coming in with like a low posture. If he's trying to go like chest to chest right away, in that case, we're gonna try to block his chest. Okay, but we're gonna start with the high guard. So he shucks it and comes in high, boom, right here. Move the hips, now the space that I created. Pull myself back in front, okay? He goes the other way, shrimp, make space. So now I can use this frame and I can hook, use my fingers, and that can help pull me to center. Okay, so I don't necessarily have to only push away with the frame. I can use that frame attached to him with my fingers, and now I can use it as a pulling force to bring myself back to center. Okay, so back up a little bit. So again, so this is a bullfighter pass with a like a high approach with his legs coming first. Boom. Boom. That's it. Yeah. All right, just find something. Okay, it's usually gonna be the legs. Again. Other way. Okay. One hand didn't touch anything, but it's still there in case something came in its way. All right, so I'm just framing, making space, and squaring back up with the person. Okay? Let's work. Okay, time. Good. Okay, so very simple. Very simple. All right. Now I'm going to approach with my chest heavy after I bullfighter pass. So now I'm going to bullfighter pass, and then I'm just diving in with my chest, man. I'm going for broke. So I'm just throwing it out and bring my chest right down. Okay? It's effective. There's very little time for him to be able to get his knees inside. Okay, so now we have to find that same type of forearm frame, right? But he's probably gonna hit my chest. Okay, and they need to be strong because he's coming in with his chest heavy. He's got all that body weight behind him. You can't like frame, right? No, boom, right? Stiff arm, right? You have to have some kind of like impact generated when you frame, right? Otherwise, they're just not really framed. They have to be strong and rigid. As I throw the legs, now you can go like lightly because we're just drilling, but that's the idea. So don't develop a weak understanding of what a frame should be, because then when you need to use the frame the way it's supposed to be, you don't have any practice. Okay, so use the frame like an intentful stop the person. Okay, so I'm gonna shuck, he's gonna fight, boom! You see that? Block, boom, perfect. Moves away, shrimp, shrimp, shrimp. Now look, just as I was talking about before, now he can use those frames, attach himself to me using his fingers. And now he's going to shoot his bottom knee in first, boom. And now whatever happens from here, maybe he decides he wants to get to a full guard, so he makes a little extra adjustments, and he gets back to full guard. Maybe from here, I disengage, and now we're back to open guard again. Okay, but he's preventing the guard pass. Okay, whether I go to open guard after that, or he ends up making adjustments, getting his knee into full guard, it can happen. So after the pass, doesn't really matter. I'm just making sure that top person from the open guard position is not able to pass your guard. Okay? So again, bullfighter pass, just a little bit. So a bullfighter pass, chest comes heavy, he blocks. He makes space, he shoots his bottom knee in, and then a lot of times the top leg's gonna come high and bite, and now he's from your clinch position, right? Now he's gonna hold me in his guard, right? And then from here he can work. And now I'm at a distance where my punches aren't effective, because now I'm really close. Right? So he's keeping me really, really far away, or really, really close. That's our understanding of distance management. If he lets me hang out in this position, this is not close but not far away, this is where he can get blasted with punches, okay? So the second I'm in that distance, he needs to do whatever he can to close the distance and clinch me or get me away to the distance where the punches aren't effective. So again, bullfighter pass, low chest, frame, shrimp, shoot the bottom knee in, okay? Bottom knee. So whatever if he tries to shoot his top knee in, yes, it might be a frame, but now, like, if I go like this, boom, he blocks, and he brings his top knee in, and I go heavy on his chest, now it's no longer a good frame. And then from here, I can start to work my way around, pass his guard, and now apply the mount. Okay? So it's very important that it's the bottom knee that comes in. So now the top leg can come over and clamp down, right? So now from here, if I belly out, there's really nothing. Yeah, now he can start to come up on top of me, and he can start, either he can pull his bottom leg out and get up, or you can start attacking triangles and like you know more advanced kind of positions from there. Okay? But you know, getting away from the point. The point is shooting that bottom knee in, not the top knee. Top knee can present problems. That's all I'm saying. One more time. Bull fighter, two hands, or one hand on each leg. Throw it away, come in chest heavy. Shrimp, shoot. And now he's here. Yes, if you like to play certain guards, after you shot them in, work to get to that guard. If you like playing full guard, make those little adjustments that you need to get to full guard so we can go through our punch block series that we've done in the past and give them the punches from the closed guard so that you can stay protected, okay? If you wanna get back to open guard, you keep making space and then get squared back up with the person, okay? Whatever you decide to do. But block, shrimp, shoot the knee in, okay? Very simple. Okay, let's work. Maybe the guy does the bullfighter pass and he throws your legs so far that he kind of puts you on your side and he exposes your back. Okay, so here's the situation. So he's gonna grab my legs and he's gonna throw them that way just to start off. So like, you see like this. Now if I try to turn and try to find that frame, my spine's all twisted up. I'm not in a very good position, okay? So if you find yourself where the guy throws your legs so far that he starts to expose your back, all right, we're gonna do something called an inversion. Okay, so we're gonna get up onto our shoulders and go basically upside down. And what this does, it's gonna cut him off to the path because instead of trying to catch up to him, I'm gonna go around, find a farther spot than what he is, where he is, and that's where I'm gonna stop his guard progression. Okay, so realistically, if he was gonna throw my legs that way, he's gonna start to run around to my back, right? If he wants to get my back and expose it. So shut my legs that way, he's gonna start to go around. You see where he's going? If I don't do anything from here, he's gonna attack my back. Okay? But I'm too far to where I can start to turn into him and stop him. Okay? So watch what we're gonna do. Okay, this is called an inversion. We're gonna do it like 40%. So a person's gonna throw the leg, start to move the other way, watch. Okay? So then notice how after he threw my legs, right? Boom, watch what I do. I get my hips nice and high. So this is what they call inversion. Okay, so boom, I get to here. I get my hips nice and high, and now my top leg, in this case, is gonna make a big, big, big circle and cut him off the path. Okay, notice how I went from being away from him to right back in front of him, right? Because I kind of went like farther than what he threw me, and I worked my way back around and cut him off to the new path. Instead of trying to catch up to the person, it's too late. The person's past our guard. So we have to create like a defensive stance farther away. It's like retreating a little bit, all right? So I'm retreating, inverting, and then coming back around to find right back in my good square position. Now you can play around with different kind of Delahiva games and all that crazy stuff, but the idea is to just get back in front of the person so we know if he's trying to punch me, I can see his hands, I can use my feet, okay? That's the idea. So again, he throws the legs, right? Hips nice and high. Watch this big leg comes around, and now I find myself right back in front of him where I can work whatever kind of guard I decide from there. Okay? But the idea is now we're back to open guard, back to the distance where we can manage his punches and get him away from us, and then we can work again. Okay? You guys want to see it again?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So slow motion, watch my footwork. I'm using the feet that he threw. I'm using them to push my hips up. They need to come up nice and high. The higher my hips are, the bigger of a circle I can make with this leg. If my hips are low, I can't make a big circle. Look up, that's the biggest I can do. If I'm really, really flexible, maybe I can, but like, this is the biggest circle I can make. It's not stopping him, right? But if I lift my hip up high, now I bring this leg all the way around, now it's a big enough arc to cut him off to whatever his new path is. Does that make sense? Okay. So it's like a little bit higher level of understanding of guard retention, but the second you understand how to invert and how to swing the leg around, it's actually very easy to prevent your guard to get past. Okay, that's kind of a last resort. Because I don't have the body position to find a frame, right? I'm like this. If I try to do that, it's gonna be too late. I'm not gonna be able to move my hips out of the way, make space, and then bring my knee back inside. There's not enough time, okay? So I have to retreat a bit, invert, and bring my leg around to cut him off to the path. Okay, let's give it a shot. All right, time, guys. All right, so we're gonna do a bonus one. This is, don't worry about it. Right? This is gonna be just a fun kind of bonus, okay? So, we're gonna combine the inversion roll with the leg weave. Okay, we're gonna combine them. So we're gonna have like a kind of a chain open guard retention drill. Okay? So this is like a chain. So if I have Sullivan down and I go leg drag, he does the leg weave. Leg drag, leg weave. Okay? I go leg drag, he goes leg weave. And now I grab his top leg. Okay? If I grab his top leg and I shove it to the floor, don't invert. If I shove it to the floor, now he's in a position where it's gonna be easy for me to start to run around and take his back. Okay? The second he feels me switch my grip to his light weave leg, he's actually going to use that connection to pull his head into me and invert himself back around. Okay? This is how it looks. You ready?
Yeah.
So I'm going to light drag. He's going to leg weave. I grab his other leg. He's going to pull himself under. See how he brings his head closer to me? And now he swings this leg all the way around. And now I cut myself off to the back. Yes. Now he's back here. Now he's got me in a really deep Dell'Aniva position. He can use this leg to push, yeah. And he's gonna bring me to the floor, and then he comes up on top, okay? So it's a very simple, not simple, I shouldn't say that. But
that one's funky.
Yeah, that was a funky one, but you notice as he inverts, he wants to get an extreme angle on me. Now I'm here, and he's over here. So I can't pass his guard, right? But he's got such an aggressive angle on me. That he can start to come up, wrestle, play Dell'Aniva games, the funky bear bowl, stuff like that, okay? So this is a fun one, okay? So this is just connecting two, because realistically, I'm not gonna just, oh, he got the leg weave and I'm gonna stop. I'm gonna continue to try to pass his guard, so I'm gonna try to get whatever in my way, out of the way, and continue the movement, okay? So again, over here, I go leg drag, he goes leg weave. I grab the leg, okay? We're not actually trying to beat the person, but I'm just grabbing the leg. Now he uses that connection. See how he pulls his head closer to me as he swings his body around? And now he's here in this kind of position. Okay, this is called Dell'Aniva. Okay, Dell'Aniva position. Okay. And with the gi, you can grab the bell and do back takes and funky stuff like that. Or if he just wants to release the Dell'Aniva, I'll sit up and take my leg to a single leg takedown and come up on top. That's what separates one. So again. Leg drag, leg weave. He grabs that leg weave, right? Look, invert, and I come all the way around. Okay, see how high my hips were? Okay, it's a fun drill where you can just continue the inversion. Whoop, and you continue the inversion.
That's how my shorts tore.
And you continue the inversion, all right?
Oh.
All right, that's a little drill that you can do to teach you how to invert and to get really smooth at it, okay? If you get really good at inverting, your guard becomes very difficult to pass because you can constantly like reset the position by spinning yourself underneath it, okay? Again, I'm not really worried about you guys doing it today, but I figure we got 5 minutes before we roll. Let's do a little slip and fun, okay? So one more time. Leg drag, leg weave, two hands on the new leg. Look, I lift my shoulders off the ground. Let's say I use this connection to lift my shoulders off the ground and I shoot my head in between his. And I work my way around, and now I'm here. Realistically, he's gonna square back up to me, and now we're right back in the open guard position where I do whatever kind of sweep that I need. Okay? Let's play around with it.